Google Analytics has an approachable, simple-to-use interface. Within the interface, there are many useful tools that you can use to manipulate the data and discover insights about your business. In this lesson, we'll walk through the reporting interface and review how to perform simple, everyday tasks, such as how to change the date range and compare data between two date ranges, how to graph data, customize trend graphs, and adjust data views, how to plot multiple rows of data to compare trends, how to quickly filter and sort data in reports, and how to adjust which metrics appear in your reports.
To access the standard reports in Google Analytics, first choose the view that contains the data you want to analyze. Once you're in the reports, you can use the calendar to set the active date range. To select the date range, click the day and month within the calendar, or type specific dates in the date range boxes. Once you set a date range, it stays active as you navigate Google Analytics, or until you change it or log out of your account. You can use a comparison date range to see how your site is performing month over month, year over year, or even from one day to another. This helps you add important internal context to your data to understand how your performance changes over time. As you can see, once the comparison date ranges are selected, they will apply to all of your reports and graphs. Most reports in Google Analytics include a time graph at the top. You can adjust this graph to display data by day, week, or month, depending on the level of granularity that makes sense as you analyze trends for your site. Within the graph, you can attach short notes or annotations to specific dates. Annotations are especially useful when you're looking at historical data and are wondering whether certain campaigns or outside events had some effect on your traffic. To add an annotation to your report, simply double-click on a date within the time graph. You can allow anyone with access to the profile to see the annotation, or you can make it private so that only you can see it. Each report in Google Analytics has a default metric displayed on the time graph. In this example, that default metric is visits. You can adjust which metric is displayed on the graph simply by clicking on the drop-down metrics menu at the top of the graph. You can also compare two metrics on the same graph to see how they are correlated. Most reports in Google Analytics contain data tables. These tables usually break out your data by a single dimension. Each row of the table shows the data for a different value of the dimension. In this example, the dimension being shown is city, and each row contains data for a different city. In this second example, each row of the table corresponds to a kind of browser: Chrome, Internet Explorer, Firefox, and so on. So this table is showing data for different values of the dimension browser. The primary dimension option above the table lets us change the dimension shown in the first column of the table. You can also add a secondary dimension to most tables in Google Analytics. Adding a second dimension lets us see data for each combination of the two dimensions. Now you can see data for each operating system and browser in combination: Windows and Chrome, Windows and Internet Explorer, Android and Android browser, and so on. In addition to adjusting which dimensions show in your reports, you can change the sets of metrics that appear. Groups of metrics in Google Analytics are organized into tabs at the top of each report. The Site Usage tab shows metrics that measure user engagement on the site, such as the number of pages viewed per visit, the average visit duration, and the bounce rate. The Goal Set tab shows the conversion rates for each of your goals. You must have an account administrator set up the goal tracking for your report view in order for these metrics to be tracked. If you've enabled e-commerce for your reports, you'll also see an e-commerce tab. Oftentimes, it is useful to filter the data that appears in your report table in order to focus only on the segments of your traffic that are significant. At the top of each data table, you'll see a search box that can help you filter your data. By default, setting this simple search filter will modify your report to include only the rows of the table where the value of the primary dimension contains the value you request. For example, if you filter for the term organic in the All Traffic Sources report shown here, all other traffic sources will be excluded from the report, and only the rows that contain the term organic will remain. In addition to filtering the table off of the primary dimension, you can use an advanced filter to set other rules for filtering your reports. For example, let's say you are looking at the GEO report and want to know which countries have the highest bounce rate. When you sort the report to show the highest bounce rate, you will likely see many rows of the report have so little data that they can't be considered significant for your analysis. To clean up the report, you can set an advanced filter that includes only the rows of the table where the metric visits is greater than 50. Now when you look at the report, you can trust that the metric bounce rate has been calculated from a significant enough population to make your analysis meaningful. The view options in your reports let you visualize data in different ways. The data view is the default option for most reports. The percentage view creates a pie chart based on your data. You can choose which metric from your report should display in the pie chart. The performance view shows a bar graph of your data. You can adjust the bar graph to be based on any metric you select. The comparison view allows you to quickly see whether each entry in the table is performing above or below average. Again, you can use the drop-down menu to select which metric should be displayed. Finally, the pivot view creates a pivot table in which both rows and columns can break out dimension values. In this example, we can see how many visits were referred by each combination of keyword and search engine. Keywords are shown as rows, and search engines are shown as columns. You can select both the metrics and dimensions you want to display when using the pivot table view. The plot rows feature lets you select specific rows or segments for the data table and then plot those values in the time graph. This feature is available in the data view and other reports that include the time graph. To plot row values, click the checkbox next to each row in the data table that you would like to see displayed in the time graph. Then click Plot Rows. Here you can see that our time graph, which was set to display the metric average visit duration, now shows a separate segmented line for each row that was selected. By default, all reports and tables display a maximum of 10 rows, but keep in mind that you can always expand the table to show more rows by adjusting the setting at the bottom of the table. As you get accustomed to using Google Analytics, you may find yourself using the same tools to create the same customized version of a report regularly. Shortcuts in Google Analytics remember your settings so you don't have to reconfigure a report each time you need it. Any adjustments you make to the report before saving the shortcut, like changing the metrics displayed in the graph or adding a secondary dimension, stay applied in the shortcut until you manually change the settings. The settings are saved even if you sign out and come back to your account later. Check out the resources in this lesson for more information on navigating the Google Analytics reports.